In and out, really?
Oh, of course, sir. Let me help you with that trunk.
Arr, that'd be right kind of you, Schubert. Thank you kindly. Now then, what manner of place might this be, as I've fetched up it?
Oh, you haven't fetched up, have you, sir? I'll go get them off.
Just a question. I'll do the gags.
Fair enough. Well, actually, it's an inn. The Admirable Bimbo.
Shiver me timbers. You don't say. Why now? Here's a stroke of luck. For it just so happens, as I need a berth to rest my weary old sea legs for a while. Somewhere I won't be disturbed by no unwelcome calls. Do you follow?
Well, not really, no.
Never mind. Tell me that. What accommodation do you have available?
I'll have to check. Hang on. Mother! Mother!
Coming!
What name do you go by that?
Jim.
Arr. Jim. Jim Lash.
That's right.
Hey.
And there you are, Jim! I just had to bring these pipes up to develop a nice crust. Well, what do you think?
Oh, I say, company. Hello, sailor. Oh, we're not Jim, all these people, how unexpected. Ahoy there, mateys! Oh, now, come on. I say ahoy there, mateys, and you don't say, oh, ruddy heck, they want us to join in. No, you say, avast behind. Then I do this visual gag, see?
Avast behind!
Oh, yes, well, I feel the same way, dears, but it's better to get it over and done with at the beginning of the show. Same tracking the same crummy gag all the way through. Right, shall we try that again?
Yeah.
I say, shall we try that again?
Yes!
Right, after three, one, two, three, ahoy there, mateys!
Avast behind!
Right, good. Thank heavens we got that out of the way. Here I know, while I've got your attention, let's try a couple of other things to get you in the mood for the rest of the evening. Let's start with some cheering, shall we? After you, Jim, strike a pose here.
Hey!
Oh, now, come on. When I said cheering, not jeering, shall we try that again? Shall we try that again?
Yes!
You're going to take some work tonight, aren't you? After you, Jim.
Hey!
You know how to do it, you know. And now, let's move on. Let's try some booing. Lovely. Oh, splash one. How about a bit of hissing? Clapping. You won't be doing that again tonight. Do you know what? You're very good at this. You're so good, I'm going to let you be in the play. You can play the part of Mole. This is the 18th century, after all. It'll be just like being in that Les Miserables. Not quite the same as Les Miserables, I must admit, but then these aren't Mayflower prices. Not even Nuffield. Now, where was I? Oh, yes, the story. Hello, sailor. Care to step inside and heave to?
No, he's already fetched up. I don't think he needs to heave to.
Top of the day to you, man. Might an old seafaring man make so bold as to inquire after your name?
He might, and don't call me Mum, it's weird.
What is it then?
Miss Ladd.
I see. And your son is?
Jim Ladd.
Right.
And his father, God rest his soul, was?
Mr. Ladd.
That's right.
Don't tell me. Alan?
No, no. Jack. Well, Jack V, actually.
Jack V, lad. Mm. Oh, yes, I know him right well.
Oh, did you really? More than I did. And you are?
Fishbones. Billy Fishbones. At your service, Mark.
Well, Mr. Fishbones, what can I do for you?
Board, lodging. Now head up there to watch ships off. And no questions asked.
How much?
5 gold pieces in advance.
Done.
Jim, take his things up. Room number 7. It's not en suite, I'm afraid, but you know what it's like this time of year with sales conferences and so on. Sales, come sales like sales on a ship. It's a joke.
Before you go, lad, I want to ask a favour. Keep a weather eye out for any seafaring woman with only one leg. If you should spy us out, it comes to me first. Understands me?
Perfectly, sir.
Ah, good boy. Great boy. Now then, here's a 3-penny bit for you, and another every week, so long as you keep your eyes skinned for that one-legged devil. Now then, grog!
Beg your pardon.
Grog! Grog, you swab! Fetch me a mug of grog, lad!
I don't think we've got any grog, Captain. How about last year, too?
Nah, I need a man's drink. Got any Campari and soda?
Oh, yes!
One of a slice of lemon and one of them lemon bellies?
Absolutely.
Right, that will do.
Grog? Swabs? Seafaring woman with only one leg? Don't think I like the sound of this. Oh, more visitors. Now watch.
Good day to you, my good woman.
Oh, it's you, Mr. Bodman. You come for your usual, and you're quite busy as it goes. Grog, swabs, and so on.
No, ma'am. I regret I am here on business, not pleasure.
Oh, shame.
What's the usual?
Never you mind!
Shall I tell you? Fisherman's pie, of course. Whatever did you think?
Doesn't matter.
We are here to relay a missive to you from His Worship Squire Polpano.
Oh, it reads as follows. Madam, keep your ill-bred gutter snipe rug rat away from my noble daughter, or I'll have him flogged and transported throughout the Shire. Signed, George Popero, MP, JP, ETC, ETC.
Is that it?
Yes.
Well, can't say fairer than that, can you?
No. Quite fair, the squire, I thought.
Absolutely. Now, any chance of that fisherman's pie?
No. But off!
But off! No!
You think you can come down here and threaten me, and I'm going to feed you off of my fish, your fish pie, by way of a thank you? What do you think, Mom? Shall I give it to him?
Yes!
Madam and a daughter who's pestering my Jim. Who does he think he is anyway? Does he think he owns the place?
He does own the place. He owns everything within 50 miles of any direction.
Well, not this if he doesn't. Now buzz off.
Well, I think that went rather well.
Oh,